So if you look at the star at night, you can see so many stars, but there are not only stars, but also many particles which we don't see by eyes, such as protons or photons or even neutrinos. They are quite busy in the universe because of their interaction among each other or some propagations or some accelerations. After their long travel, they arrive at the Earth, and we can measure them. But most of them are still unknown where they come from or how they can get so high energies. So the astroparticle physicist like me is doing to figure out the answers of the questions by observing the particles from the space. So what is then astroparticle physics? The astroparticle physics is a merge of particle physics with astrophysics and cosmology, where we study elementary particles of astronomical origins and their relations. So we try to understand our universe better by investigating these topics. For example, what makes up dark matters? Or does neutrino have a mass? There are so many open questions which we have to figure out, but today I focus on the cosmic rays. So the cosmic rays were discovered in 1912 by Victor Hess, the father of cosmic ray research with a balloon flight. So he observed an additional radiation coming from space at an altitude of 5,000 meters in a balloon. And he received a Nobel Prize. So actually, the balloon flight was his hobby. So if you combined well your hobby and your work, you may get also a Nobel Prize. So his adventurous journey made a physicist to study cosmic rays. So the cosmic ray whose origin is unknown are energetic particles which continually bombard the Earth and even through our bodies. So they are mostly protons and some heavier nuclei. So the flux of cosmic rays observed at the Earth has a power-law distribution. So it's strongly falling as a function of the energies. So the slope of the distribution changes because of their different sources. So the most dominant feature of the distribution is so-called by knee and an ankle at the energies about 10 to the 15 and a few 10 to the 18 electron volts. So the electron volt is the convenient energy unit which we use generally in physics, and I will use it also sometimes in this talk. So the knee present the transition from the galactic sources such as supernova remnants to extragalactic sources like active galactic nuclei or black holes. So the best way to detect cosmic ray is using atmosphere. So in atmosphere or outside the atmosphere. So this is done actually by satellite or balloon experiment. However, it's not always possible because the flux of cosmic rays decreases dramatically, increasing with energies. So we can measure only one particle per square meter per year. For example, for 10 to the 15 electron volt energy cosmic rays. But we are lucky. The atmosphere itself can act as a large detector. So above higher or ultra-high energy cosmic rays, so above 10 to the 15 electron volts, we have to measure the cascade of particles which generated in the atmosphere, so-called by extensive air showers. So what is then extensive air showers? An energetic cosmic rays arrive the upper atmosphere with explosive energies and colliding with atoms and created a shower of particles which grows as a cascade containing millions or even billions particles over many kilometers wide. So such an extensive air showers can be measured by the Cascade and its extension, Cascade Grande experiment. So the Cascade experiment was located at KIT in Karlsruhe, covering area of 200 by 200 square meters with more than 250 detector stations. So the operation for the data accumulation were successfully completed at the end of 2013, after more than 20 years measurement. But still, the high quality measured data by Cascade is interested in the astroparticle physics community. And also we obtained many fruitful achievements. In particular, for the first time, we observed the knee structure in the energy spectrum of cosmic rays. You can see here a nice result of knee structure around the energy at 10 to the 15 electron volt, well overlapping with a soccer player, Thomas Müller's leg. So even though the Cascade experiment was completed, the data taking, and we revealed very important results in the cosmic ray physics, but still the data is quite interested in the community. Therefore, we published the measured data in the frame of the KCDC project. So the Cascade Cosmic Ray Data Center, KCDC, is a web-based platform to provide scientific data for general public. So the main goal for KCDC is to archiving the original research data, such as from Cascade, and also to offer long-term scientific data for community and also school students. So the web portal of KCDC has a quite intuitive and clear design. So you can access the data free and unlimited upon registrations. And the license for open data is based on the EULA model. So the one more important goal for public data release is the education. So I'll tell you here a funny story. One day, when my daughter was 6 years old, she got to know about the black hole. And she told me, "Mom, we have to practice to running escape from the black hole." And of course, I laughed a lot. But she was so serious and scared quite a long time. And at the end, I even explained to her about the white hole as a solution. And after that, she became calm down, more or less. But what I want to say here with this funny story is the children and the school students are always curious and very interested in the astronomical object and also our universe. Therefore, for the public release data, the education aspect and also outreach program are quite important. And for that, we are doing also in KCDC. So we provide some simple examples of data analysis for school students, and also we develop it continually. So the KCDC is already well accepted in the astroparticle physics community, and it's a forerunner in public data release in the astroparticle physics, and also it's the first step toward a global analysis and data center. So why we need a global analysis and data center in astroparticle physics? So the main reason is because of the multi-messenger analysis. So there are extrasolar messengers such as gamma rays, which is photons, neutrinos, and cosmic rays. So they are originated by the same sources, but generated by different astrophysical processes. Therefore, eventually they reveal some different information about their sources. So combining all this different information, we may know better about their sources and also their interaction mechanism. Additionally, the astroparticle physics experiments are globally distributed. For example, Pierre Auger Observatory, looking for the ultra-high energy cosmic ray, is located in Argentina, and IceCube Neutrino Observatory is at the South Pole, and Cherenkov Telescope Array, looking for the gamma rays, will be in Spain and Chile. So, one global data analysis center is highly demanded in the astroparticle physics community. It's not only for Germany, but also internationally. So the required element for the global data center is data availability, open access, education, and data archiving, and the simulation development, and of course, the analysis. And all these elements are eventually related with open science. So the next step is toward the global data center is to develop an open science system based on the KCDC, and we have to develop also an integrated solution of distributed data storage algorithms and techniques. And of course, we should make allowing community to perform the multi-messenger analysis, for example, based on the machine learning. So, think about, in a few years from now, you will sit at your sofa at home and count the flux of cosmic rays and feel like Victor Hess in his balloon. So thanks to KCDC, and don't miss this moment. Stay tuned. Thank you very much.